Hi, it's Milena. Welcome to my channel. Today I want to chat with you guys about all the unread classics on my shelves. I asked you guys on Instagram what you would rather hear me talk about, the classics I read in 2020 or the classics I plan to read in 2021. As you can see, I have my bookshelves behind me, and today we're going through the classics that I have not read yet. And to be honest, 2020 was the year where I bought a lot of classics, where I got very greedy, and of course I blame BookTube and Bookstagram. I want to start with books that I've partly read that are collections of things, of novels or of short stories, and then I have a few translated classics, but most of my unread classics are American or British classics. The two books I have read partially are this collection of shorter work by Jane Austen. I have only read Sanditon. It has Lady Susan and I believe some character sketches she wrote when she was younger, and I believe she called that The History of England, and that is supposed to be really funny. The other book I have partially read is the collection of Quicksand and Passing by Nella Larsen. Those are the only two novels she wrote, and I have read Passing, her second novel with the book club, but I have not yet read Quicksand, which was her debut novel. My translated classics are, the first one is The Master and Margarita by Mikhail Bulgakov, which is one of the two Russian classics I bought because of BookTube. So this is the first one, which is translated from the Russian to Dutch. Then I have a book for which I blame Caroline Marie Reads 100% for buying, and that is Anna Karenina by Lev Tolstoy, which is translated from the Russian to Dutch. Then I have a book that I pre-ordered but still haven't read, and that is 30 of Light by Yuko Tsushima. It is translated from the Japanese to Dutch, or I'm not even sure if it's directly translated or that it's translated from the English translation. No, I think it is translated from the Japanese to Dutch. Then the last translated work is Madame Bovary by Gustave Flaubert, which is translated from the French to Dutch, which was a Christmas present I got this year. I have two unread poetry collections. First is Poems from the Moor by Emily Bronte. I have read some poetry by Emily Bronte, which was in a little back cassette, but this is a much larger collection that I think probably has hundreds of poems. And the second unread poetry collection was one that you guys recommended to me, and that is a poetry collection by Mary Oliver. This was the one that she won the Pulitzer Prize with, I believe, and it is called American Primitive. Okay, so those are all the books that were in my write closet, but most of my unread classics are right over here. I have some Jane Austen that I of course have read at some point. I have my cloth-bound editions that I've all read. Which I haven't read is Winter in Mallorca by George Sand, which was written in 1838, and this is a really nice edition of that book. A very big book I haven't read is Bleak House by Charles Dickens. I read this last year during Victober when I read Oliver Twist, and I was thinking that maybe Bleak House would be more for me, so I bought a beautiful Everyman's Library copy of the book. I have three copies of the English Penguin Library editions that I have not yet read. The first one is Villette by Charlotte Bronte. I got a secondhand copy through Bookstagram, I believe, of this book, but it's in very nice condition, and this is together with surely the Bronte novels that I still have left to read. I have a copy of Far From the Man in Crowd by Thomas Hardy. During Victober in 2020 I read Tess of the D'Urbervilles and I absolutely loved it, so I'm pretty sure I will love this as well. Then a book of one of my favorite authors, which is Edith Wharton, is The House of Mirth. Last year I read Ethan Frome and I read The Age of Innocence, so I'm really looking forward to this. I believe the themes are quite similar, so I'm sure I will enjoy this. One of the biggest books on my unread pile is both in page count and in how hefty it is, a very big book, which is Middlemarch by George Eliot. I have heard so many mixed things about it. Lots of people have warned me not to start with George Eliot with Middlemarch, but I can't help myself. I'm so curious for this book, especially because it's supposed to be about a lot of different characters, and the book also discusses politics, which really sounds like my cup of tea. And I'm planning on reading this in the summer. I have two big books I really want to read this year, and that's Anna Karenina and this one. I'm planning on reading Anna Karenina in the winter. I want to start that soon, and I'm planning to read this one in the summer. As you can see behind me, this upper shelf has now become a mess because most of my unread classics are on this shelf. First of which, I am not sure I should have bought this edition, but I did, I think. about 2 years ago, and that is The Best of Sherlock Holmes by Sir Arthur Conan Doyle. I did read A City in Scarlet, which is not in this collection, I believe. I'm not really sure how much I liked it. This is a collection of 15 Sherlock Holmes stories, so I'm sure that if I feel in the mood for some crime, for something Sherlock Holmes, I can pick this up whenever I like. I just haven't yet. Talking about crime, I have one more book that I think won through Instagram, and that is The Mysterious Affair at Stiles by Agatha Christie. This is a really small and cute 1980s copy, I believe. I have now read two novels by Elizabeth Gaskell. I do have a secondhand copy of Wives and Daughters. Again, this book is something that has a lot of mixed reactions, but I know that Kate from Kate House Channel really loves this book. I believe it's one of her favorite classics, so I think this may be something that I wanna keep for Victober. Last year I read Beloved, and it was my favorite book of the year. I still feel comfortable saying that because it's so hard to just pick one favorite, but that definitely had a big impression on me. So last year, after reading Beloved, I got two more Toni Morrison books, one of which was Tar Baby. This is one of her lesser known works, I believe. It is a love story about two people who have different connections to their community and to their identity. I'm happy I got a secondhand, also 1980s copy, I believe, of this one. The book by Toni Morrison I want to read second is The Bluest Eye, which is her debut novel, and it is about a young girl and her family, and I'm really very curious for this. This one I got for my birthday, I believe, in 2020, and that is Morris by Ian Forster, which I think is very interesting, especially the background of the author, and that he only was able or comfortable to publish this after he died. A book I will probably have started by the time I upload this is The Color Purple by Alice Walker. This is also the most recent book I bought because I got it for our book club pick for February. And this is another classic that was highly anticipated by me, and a lot of people recommended this to me. Okay, so I'm going to check, but I think those were the unread classics on my shelves, but give me a minute. Yes, I think I got them all. Let's count them. Okay, if I got this right, I have 19 unread classics on my shelves, which honestly, I thought there were more. Not that having 19 unread classics on your shelf and still buying them monthly isn't a bad thing. Mainly when I buy classics, it's for the book club, so I justify it that way. I think it's pretty likely that I will read most of these books. I think, like, if I'm looking at the bigger books like Wives and Daughters, Bleak House, that all kind of depends how I want to participate in Victober in 2021, because I definitely think those are the kind of books I want to save for that very special and fun month every year. If any of these unread classics are your favorites, please let me know which books I should prioritize. In all clarity, I am waiting for a parcel that contains 4 classics. So the next video on this channel will probably be a classics book haul, I'm not going to lie. But I had a lot of fun showing you the unread classics on my shelf. I hope you enjoyed watching, and if you did, don't forget to subscribe so you can see reading vlogs in which I attempt to read this pile of books. And I hope to see you in another video. Doei!